are not worth comparing with the glory that is going to be revealed to us. For the creation eagerly waits with anticipation for God's sons to be revealed. For the creation was subjected to futility, not willingly, but because of Him who subjected it, in the hope that the creation itself will also be set free from the bondage of corruption into this glorious freedom of God's children. For we know that the whole creation has been groaning together with labor pains until now. And not only that, but we ourselves, who have the Spirit as the first fruits, we also groan within ourselves, eagerly waiting for adoption, the redemption of our bodies. Now in this hope, we were saved. Yet hope that is seen is not hope, because who hopes for what he sees? But if we hope for what we do not see, we eagerly wait for it with patience. In the same way, the Spirit also joins to help in our weakness. This is awesome. Okay, listen. This is awesome. In the same way, the Spirit also joins to help in our weakness, because we do not know what to pray for as we should, but the Spirit himself intercedes for us with unspoken groanings. And he who searches the hearts knows the Spirit's mindset, because he intercedes for the saints according to the will of God. We know that all things work together for the good of those who love God, those who are called according to his good purpose. For those he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, so that he would be the firstborn among many brothers. And also he predestined, he also called. And those he called, he also justified. And those he justified, he also glorified. And so it's pretty amazing here. Paul paints this beautiful picture that all of creation, the world, the earth, the people, everything is like, has this groaning, like eagerly waiting for its creator to come and redeem it all. And the truth is, as we're waiting for Jesus to come and restore everything and make it perfect as it was meant to be, we are being conformed to his image. But we're not alone. Even in our good times and our bad times, it says the Spirit intercedes for us. Jesus himself, he's our intercessor, and he's praying for you. He's praying for me. He's with us. So even when we don't know how to pray, when we don't know what to say, we can just get in tune with the Spirit and just know that he is fighting for us. He's fighting on our behalf, that he knows what he's doing. And we can trust him because God is faithful. He never, ever, ever will fail us. He'll never forsake us. He'll never leave us. His plan will always come to pass. And it says he works all things together for the good of those who are called according to his purpose. That means even in the good times and bad times, no matter how it appears to us, we have hope. Because God is working all things together for the good of those who are called according to his purpose. And Jesus came and paid the ultimate price to redeem you and me. And all we got to do is trust him. And so tonight, I want you to lay aside all the worries, all the fears, all the doubt, all the anxiety, all the things that try to creep in, that try to get you fearful and to back away or to be depressed, or, you know, all these different things that come into our mind. I want you to lay them all down and know that God is fighting for you. He is with you. You are not alone. And he's going to work it all out. And it's going to be good. If it's not good right now, that means he's not done. He is going to work everything together for the good of those who love him, those who are called according to his purpose. And one day, Jesus is going to come back. He's going to restore everything. It's going to be perfect and good. But until then, we are going to worship him. We're going to lift up his name. We're going to put our hope, trust, and faith in him, because he is good and he is faithful. So I'm going to pray, and then we're going to worship tonight. And I invite you to stand up or to get on your knees or whatever you need to do to really get in the presence of God, to lay down all the junk that's keeping you from worshiping him fully, and just to go for it tonight. Worship with us in spirit and truth. Father, we love you so much. We thank you, Jesus. Thank up to something, that you're doing something. So we will not be fearful. We will not be anxious. We will trust in your name, Jesus. And right now, we will just worship you, because that's what we were created to do. We were created to worship you and to glorify you with everything we do. So tonight, whether it's on a phone, whether it's on the computer, whether it's here, whatever it is, we're going to join together and lift up your name, Jesus, because you are worthy of it all. And you are faithful. It's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen.
Through it all, through it all. Thank you. To the end of yourself, do you? Thank you. Love y'all. Have a good week.